Thank you very much for joining us. This is our 9th lecture on UAE economic substance regulations. We are discussing relevant activities. Out of the 9, 5 relevant activities we have already discussed, and today we are discussing shipping business. They said if the licensee is operating ships in the international traffic, then it will be subject to ESR, otherwise it will not be subject to ESR. They have given the definition of ships. They said fishing vessel, small vessel which can carry less than 10 tons, or lighter vessels which includes cruise ship or private yachts. Moreover, these ships are being used in the international traffic to transport either passengers or cargo or both. Important thing is, in the shipping business, it doesn't matter who is the owner of the ship. We need to look into this, who is operating the ship. If someone is operating the ship, and these ships are being used in the international traffic, then it will be subject to ESR. Moreover, they said if someone is operating ships and following these activities will be considered as a shipping business. These activities are rental on charter basis of ships, sale of tickets, use, maintenance or rental of container, management of the crew of the ship, it will be subject to ESR, provided that these activities are being carried out by the same party who is operating the ships. Moreover, it has been written in the guide that if the ships are being chartered out on bareboat basis, it will not be subject to ESR. Chartering of ships on bareboat basis means chartering of ships without crew. So means the person who is getting the ship on lease, that person will operate the ships, that person will hire the crew, that person will manage the crew. The party who is giving the ships on lease, or the party who is chartering the ships, and these are the bare boat ships, then it will not be subject to ESR. Moreover, they said the middlemen or travel agencies who are arranging the tickets only, but they are not operating the ships, it will not be subject to ESR. And the parties who are arranging the goods that require to be transported either in the international traffic or in the local traffic even, it will not be subject to ESR. These are the core income generating activities. If these are being performed in UAE, then we will say that SIGA test is being met. These activities are that managing crew in UAE, overhauling or maintaining ships in UAE, overseeing and tracking ships in UAE, and organizing and overseeing voyages in UAE. So if these activities are being happen in UAE, then we will say that SIGA test is being met. Which one is the regulatory authority? This is Ministry of Economy, competent authority in the free zone, competent authority in the financial free zone. Now we will look into the examples which has been given in the guide. In the first example, Water LLC is operating ships from UAE to other GCC country, means they are operating ships in the international traffic, so it will be subject to ESR. Sailor Corporation, this company is managing only crew, but this company is not operating the ships, so it will not be subject to ESR. In the third example, they said Charter LLC owns the ship, and this company charter the ships on bareboat basis to Cargo LLC. Then Cargo LLC is operating the ship, so charter is the owner of the ship, charter is giving the ship on lease, charter is chartering out the ships to Cargo LLC, and Cargo LLC is operating the ship, so Charter LLC will not be subject to ESR. and the party who is operating the ship, and this party is Cargo LLC, this party will be subject to ESR. Thank you very much for joining us.